Hello, happy Saturday, happy weekend. How's everyone doing? I just wanted to do a hair journey update for you guys. It'll be 3 months. I'm locked on September 1st, and I'm super excited about that. And since my last video, I've definitely noticed some change and differences in my hair. So I wanted to tell you guys that I felt like I was posting a lot, and it really wasn't much really going on in my hair. And I don't really want to post as much unless I have something really worth talking about. So now I do feel like I have something worth talking about, because now I'm noticing that throughout my head there are a few locks that have about 2 and 3 buds in it. So that's super exciting. I didn't even notice that, and it's only because I'm finally not looking at my hair every single day. So the ones in the front are still like really loose and straggly a little bit, but I think they're finally getting to lock. So this is how I normally wear my hair for the most part. Sometimes I'll put it up with a pin, I'll put it in a ponytail. If I'm running, I'll put it, you know, in a tight bun if I can. Hey girl, how are you? So I'm gonna see if I can find the locks that I have in my hair that have about 2 and 3 buds in them. So bear with me, because I've been feeling them and I've been super excited, like, oh my gosh, it's doing stuff. Let me see if I can find one for you guys that I know I have a few different buds in it. Okay, so here's one. I'm not sure if you can see it. Hey friend, how are you? Happy Saturday. So that one right there, so there's a bump there. That's considered a bud. And at the base, there's another one. So there's one here, and then there's one here. So I have a few more that have a few like that too. Let me see, I think this is another one. Not sure if you can see so good. So this one, thank you girl, thank you. I dedicate this Instagram page to my whole lock journey. So this is another one. It's getting really full, it's expanding a lot, it's getting super thick. So there's a bud here, and I think there's one here too. So I'm really excited to, like, you know, notice that. And also my roots are super thick and puffy. That's because I've been working out a lot and everything, indoors and outdoors. Thank you girl, I really appreciate it. I just wanted to do my hair in locks because I'm super lazy, and I feel like I was loose natural for a few years, and I definitely got tired of doing that. Tired of every night have to retwist, rewash, repin, recurl. So I'm like, you know what, I need something that's simple, I can just go with it. And I feel like this is gonna be it. Initially, it's gonna take a while for my hair to lock up and for it to do what it's gonna do. So right now I'm during the phase where it's like the ugly phase, they call it. It's not doing everything I wanted to do, but it's okay because I'm really loving it. Like, I feel like it fits my face, you know, although it's like at my neck level. Yeah, you know, I think it fits me, but just, you know, liking to see the change in my hair. I have a few that really are struggling to lock. Like, for example, this one here, these two ones in the front, they get really loose and straggly. I can't help that though, they do what they do, but they gonna make it. I'm rooting for them. The ones in the back are really tight and curly. So let me see, you guys can see that these are all my back ones. They're really puffy, and they're really curly, and they're really fuzzy, and I like what they're doing. They're super cute. They're kind of bendy and twirly and flippy and floppy or whatever case is, but I'm sure eventually they'll grow out of that and they'll do what they're supposed to do. Excuse me. But if you look at my roots, you can still see some of my parts. So I have the fan part, I believe they call this. And so far, you know, my hair is starting to get tangled together, so I find myself putting my fingers through my hair to make sure I can, like, pop them, because my loctician did tell me that I'm currently at the stage where now I may have to get my locks cut when I'm coming to do my retwist, because, you know, excuse me, they're doing things now, and, you know, at some point they do get kind of, like, you know, stuck together. You may have to, like, pull them apart literally. So that's what happens. You can still see some of my parts here. They're definitely here, but I have, like, so much new growth and unraveling that, you know, just really can't tell. But I love the decision to lock my hair. I don't regret it. I don't feel like I'm going to take it out anytime soon. I can just imagine myself futuristically, it being on my shoulders, you know, maybe rinsing them, doing a henna color to them possibly. But I really, really love where my hair looks. So this one here in the front is one of the struggle ones because it took forever to lock. And it's kind of quite not locked, but there's a bud right there in the front, I think, right there. But you know, the rest of it is kind of like still straight, but you know, it is what it is. And same thing with this one here in the front too. This one's actually, I think, locking though. You can see right here at the top. Oh, where'd it go? I lost it. Okay, there I go. So that one right there at the top, that's a bud. That's doing something right there. And I think right here is trying to do something too. So I'm very happy at the progress it's making. Yeah, you know, but when I realized too, you know, as we get older, like the texture definitely changes. So it still looks really thick and puffy and everything, but you know, it's definitely more easily to be damaged and break off and everything like that. So I should do a hot oil treatment. I haven't done a hot oil treatment in a while, or like some kind of deep conditioner, but I haven't. I was doing a Spanish deep conditioner for a while. It was eggs, mayonnaise, olive oil, and I think it was avocado. Put it in my hair for like an hour or two, rinse it out, and my hair would be really nice and straight and shiny. Even on my natural hair, it was like really, really like fine and like rich looking. So I still have some of those qualities, but not all of them. So I'm wondering how my hair texture is gonna change now that it's gonna be locked, you know, like, am I gonna experience dryness? Am I gonna experience, you know, itchy scalp? Or I don't know, because I know it's different than me being loose natural. So I'm trying to pay close attention to what everything's gonna do as far as my hair. I read a lot of YouTube reviews and comments. I see a lot of people say that, you know, you can't necessarily use all the same exact products and methods you use on your loose natural hair on your lock journey. So I'm gonna figure it out. I think I wanna do the best I can to keep my hair healthy. So I think I'm gonna keep it black initially, but I think I definitely wanna try like a color, like maybe a henna at some point. You know, for the tips, the ends. I like when I see people with their ends of their dress one color, then a roots another color, and then 6 months later, it grows out. It's like they have an ombre color going on. So I definitely want to try that, but I don't want to dye my own hair because I just feel like dyes and bleaches and chemicals is always going to end up being bad. But see if I can like turn around a little bit so that you see like the back of my hair. It's the back of my big old head. That all looks like in there. That jungle, the safari. Yeah, so I'm gonna keep it super natural, but I'm gonna wait though. I'm gonna definitely wait. Probably in the summertime I'll come out with that. But I think I'm gonna do something simple like a color spray initially, like, you know how they had the jazzing little rinses, you know, something like that. I'm gonna be really skeptical as far as the dye because I don't want to damage my hair. You know, we did so much to our hair, and at this point now at this age, I feel like anything we do to it, we may lose it. You know what I'm saying? So I ain't trying to lose my hair. I'm trying to preserve and keep whatever else I have. And reading a lot of information online, I see a lot of people say that, you know, with the lock hair community, you experience something called growth spurts as your hair is locked. So I think I may go through a growth spurt in month 4. So I'm excited to see what that may be about. Not really quite sure though, but I know everyone's journey will be a little bit different from mine's, but if I go through that, that's gonna be super dope. Can't wait to see it. But I'm definitely getting used to doing more of my hair. Like now I'm not afraid to put it up like this. I normally have a bun sometimes like this when I'm running in the morning. I have a bun, or I put it in a ponytail now. Like, I'm so not afraid to touch it or do anything. Like, if the first few months, I was like so afraid to touch it and do stuff to it because I just felt like I don't want to mess it up. I like putting it behind my ear like this sometimes. And when it's freshly washed and retwisted, it always lays somewhat like this. Like this part is always this way, I think, or it's to the side of my mole or something like that. But now I'm getting used to it, you know, even when it's not freshly done, you know, even with it looking like this, I'm starting to like this look. I'm starting to not always want that fresh, tight look. You can see my whole scalp and everything shiny and neat and long, like a wet jerry curl. Like, now I'm like, oh, that style is cute, but I like this too, because when it's like this, it's like I'm free, I can go with it. You know, I don't have to do much, but, you know, pull out my little baby hairs. And that's that. So, I definitely want to stay as natural as possible with it and not do too much, but I can't wait so I can get to the part where I can actually start putting beads and like little shells and gold wires and all kind of things in. I can't wait to do that. But so far on my lock journey, I started my locks on June 1st. September 1st will be my 3-month mark. So I'm about 80, 90 something days in right now at this point. So 3 months is coming real soon. Well, not 90 days, I'm probably around 80-ish, 81, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, something like that. I'm around that time frame, so I'm so excited. I haven't experienced anything negative yet besides me working out a lot and my scalp sweating and, you know, it looking like this. This is like the most negative thing I experienced so far. I haven't experienced any hair loss, any itching, any dry scalp, like I said. I'm still not using a lot of products because I just don't want to put so much in my hair. I don't want buildup. I want it to feel free like this. I like how it feels. It doesn't feel heavy. It doesn't feel like I'm smacking myself in the face with like a fish or something. It feels so light. But it does feel like there's some weight to it. So I'm happy that it feels like some weight. When I first got my locks done, I went like this. I felt like it didn't even move. You know, so I like that I have this movement. And I'm afraid to put too much product in it because I hear a lot of people say the more product you put in your hair, the heavier your hair feels. Also, I haven't tried to wash my own hair yet. That's something I want to do, but I'm scared. I tried to retwist my hair once. Disaster-ish. It didn't come out the way I wanted it to. So I'm like, Maybe when I get to the point where I can just palm roll my hair. And I don't really know that method, but I know it goes something like this. They do that and your hair is just locked. So maybe when I get to that process, I can, you know, start doing more with it. But I'm still really nervous and scared to venture and like do stuff to it myself. But maybe after the 3-month mark, I'll be more bold and courageous. I see a lot of information about, you know, after the first 6 months, you'll be good. So I'm looking at my 3-month mark as like my crutch and my clutch. You know, I'm hoping by month 6, which should be about December-ish, you know, I'm hoping that, you know, I won't experience any unraveling at all. I have a few friends that are locked and they said that it took them years for their dress to not unravel, especially during the workout. So I'm a little stressed and worried about that process. You know, I hope that's not really true, but I trust the people and I work with some of these people and I look at their social media pages from when they first started their hair to now. So I don't think people have any reason to lie to me. So, you know, hopefully my journey will be a little bit different. Maybe hopefully I can beat that phase and be out of that little realm of my hair unraveling in less than a year or less than years. I hope so. I haven't found any remedies that I want to use or start yet. My oldest daughter uses rice water to wash her hair. She says it makes her hair grow. So I've thought about doing that, but again, I haven't started washing my own hair yet. I'm still very nervous and scared to venture to do much to my hair besides pull down my baby hairs and attempt to retwist them with this lock gel I found. But hopefully soon I'll be bold enough and courageous to do that, but I still haven't done that yet. But one thing I did notice, I counted all of the locks in my hair and I think I have a total of 66 locks. I think that's hot shit. because I took the time to count them. And I did it a few times, so I feel like there's a possibility that I could be off a number or two, but I think I got the right count. So, just want to get a little bit closer, just to dig in my hair. You guys can really see what it looks like in there. Feel like, you know, maybe you don't really see it good. There's a little bub there, looking like a little knot to me. I'm here for it. Shine through, baby. Show your work. So you see these little straight ones here? these ones really stressed me out because this is the front of my hair where, of course, when I would go to the Dominicans, get a wash and set, this is the part they would blow the F out of, the hell out of, you know, to get that nice straight bang or bump. So the front of my hair is really different. It's really limp. And I feel like it's going to take a longer time for my locks to lock up here because of that. So I keep saying, oh, next time I get my hair locked, I'm going to get a style, I'm going to get a style. But I didn't ask to get a style last time. So I need to really remember that. But here's a nice one. Super cute. She got some chunkiness there. Ow. I like that. That's dope. Here's another nice one. One thing I want to try to do too, I want to not have lint in my locks. I hate when I see people with locks and they're so dirty and linty and like there's stuff in it. I don't want that. Check this out. This is my little bae too. See, I don't know if this hair, if this is growth or if this is just unraveling. Hopefully I'll soon be able to learn the difference. But here's another close up of a little boo boo. I like this one too. She's cute. Super cute. I like her. She always hangs straight for the most part. She doesn't get too crazy. This one I like a lot as well. Super chunky, confident, curvy, curvaceous. Notice how I'm talking about them like they're like physical females. Because I am female. She is female. I am all female. Even my hair. They say some people look at their hair as strength. I guess I can dig it. I love this one too. This one is so unique to me. I like the texture and the form that it has. And it never unravels this one. I like it a lot. It has a weird shape to it, kind of, sort of, though. You know, it's like doing a whole bunch of different things. You see, it has like a few buffs. So here's one of them that has like two in it. See that? One, two. Actually, there's one here too. So three. One, two, three. Oh, one, two, three. I found one with four. See? Told you. My hair in here doing stuff. So that's what this update is about. I'm realizing that now I have a few locks to have, maybe three and four buds in it. That's amazing. Everything you do is amazing. I got what you need. Yeah. So, love that. Let's check this side. Oh, look at her. Like, I feel like she's shrinking this one. But this one is super dope, too. It's, like, getting really ruly. It's, like, it's taking up a whole bunch of hair and just doing what it wants in there. But this one shrinks a lot as well. Another nice one back here. Super dope. So that's it. That's all for my little live video. Just showing you what my hair looked like deep down in the roots in the dirty. You can't really see up close. So now for you who look at me and I'm working out, you're like, what does she have on her hair? What is she doing? Now you know what it is. Locks. I started with comb for you locks and almost 3 months into my journey, and this is what it is. So thank you, Aretha, for tuning into my live video. As always, I love and appreciate you always tuning into my videos, commenting, liking. Have a great day, everybody.